Hello friends, welcome to the video on NMAT 2019. Here we will be discussing the important dates, exam pattern, cutoff, exam cost and application process. Okay, so the important dates, as we all know, the registration has already started from 2nd of July and it will be open till 3rd of October. They also have late registration process, but we are not interested in it because that is going to cost us more. The exam dates are starting from 4th of October to 17th of December, which is a 75 days window. This is a 75 days window in which you can appear for NMAT 3 times. Okay. Then retake scheduling can start from 5th of October to 14th of December. So what are retakes? I'll explain you later in this video. NMIMS, they have some 6-7 campuses across India, and the Mumbai campus, and in Mumbai campus they provide MBA, PGDM, Pharma and HR. These are the four programs which they provide in Mumbai campus. Rest all the campus like Bangalore, Shirpur, Hyderabad, Indore, Navi Mumbai, Dhule, they provide only PGDM. There are other major colleges which accept NMAT score. There are somewhat 20-25 colleges who accept NMAT score. The good amongst them are these: SPJ Mumbai, XIM Bhubaneswar, ISB Hyderabad, TAPMI Manipal, IBS Hyderabad, VIT Vellore and SDA Mumbai. Okay, so these are the good colleges. Then there are few other colleges like MIT and then Shiv Nadar University. All these colleges, they also NMAT score. Okay, let's look at the exam pattern. So total there are 3 sections. Total number of questions are 120. Verbal section will have 32 questions, which needs to be solved in 22 minutes. QA section will have 48 questions, which needs to be solved in 60 minutes. And LR section, 40 questions, which needs to be solved in 30 minutes. Total 120 questions in 120 minutes. Each question is of 3 marks, and that is why the total marks will be 360 marks. There is no negative marking in NMAT. Okay. Also, one more thing which NMAT provides is that you can decide the order in which you can appear for the different sections. For example, let's say at the start of the exam, they'll ask you which is your first preference or which section you want to solve the first. Maybe you say quant, and then which is the section you want to solve second. Maybe you say verbal. So like this, whatever is your choice, you can be, you can choose your sections or the order of the section according to you. Okay, this is the only thing which NMAT provides, something which is different. Okay, so cutoffs for the NMAT college, the best amongst them is NMIMS Mumbai, which provides the MBA program. The cutoff of it has been 208-209 since last 10 years. So it has been stagnant there. Also NMIMS PGDM, the cutoff reduces a bit. NMIMS Bangalore and Hyderabad, again the cutoff reduces much more. There is sectional cutoff, so you need to score good in all the sections and overall as well. The most difficult section amongst these is verbal one. So verbal section will have RC questions, some 8 to 12 RC questions, then some 10 odd grammar questions, 10 questions on grammar, some 7-8 questions on verbal logic. What is verbal logic? Verbal logic means your parajumbles, critical reasoning, statement, assumption, statement, conclusion and all these. And some 2, 3, 4 questions on vocabulary. Like synonym, antonym, fill in the blanks and all. Quant section is very easy. 20 questions for DI and 28 questions for quant. And major focus on quant is on topics of arithmetic. Okay, LR, they do ask some puzzles in LR, but major focus is on topics like input-output, blood relation, direction sense, coding, decoding, all these. So overall, QA and LR, they become very easy, but verbal is the toughest one. Not because of the number of high number of questions and low amount of time. Also, the difficulty level of the questions in verbal is very high. And to score 55 marks out 55 marks from these 32 questions. 32 questions into 3 marks will be 96 marks, correct? So out of 96 marks, we need to score 55 marks, which is approximately 18-19 questions. So 19 questions, getting it correct in 22 minutes is a big task in NMAT exam. Okay. Next thing is the application process and exam date selection. This is something which you will never get on internet. Okay. So NMAT has a 75 days window. 75 days window, which they have divided into 5 slots. Slot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Of 15 days each. Okay, so slot 1 will start from 4th of October till 18th of October will be slot 1. From 19th of October to 2nd, 3rd of November will be slot 2, and so on till 17th of December. Okay, so as you know that NMAT can be appeared 3 times, okay, but you cannot appear it on any dates. In one slot you can appear only once, okay. So you cannot appear for NMAT on 10th of October and 14th of October because they fall in same slot. So out of these 5 slots you will have to select maybe these 3 slots, and from these 3 slots you will have to appear for the exams, okay. So you may select first slot, fourth slot, fifth slot, or you may select first slot, second slot and fifth slot. You can appear once per slot. Total out of 5 slots you will have to select 3 slots, and on these 3 slots you will appear once per slot. Okay, got it? Now NMAT, as we all know, is a very costly exam. So NMAT, what will happen, you will have to appear for the exam. Okay, if you are not satisfied with your score, you will appear for retake 1. If you are still not satisfied, you will appear for retake 2. Okay, so that retake scheduling which we had in on first slide, which starts from 5th of October until 14th of December. So these are those retake schedulings. But for the exam, for first attempt, you will have to register between these dates only. Okay. So now for exam you will have to pay 2500 rupees plus applicable taxes. For retake, if you want to appear for one retake, you will have to pay 2000 rupees plus taxes, and retake 2 will be again 2000 rupees plus taxes. They also provide a facility to reschedule your exam. Let's say you have decided that you are going to appear for NMAT on, let's say, 5th of November, but you are not satisfied with your preparation and you want to reschedule it to maybe 15th of November, then they provide that facility, and for that it will cost you around 1100 rupees plus applicable taxes. Okay. Now NMAT, you will also have to apply for the colleges. Let's say you apply for the Mumbai campus for MBA program, that will be 1300 rupees extra. For PGDM program, again 1300 rupees extra. For HR, again 1300 rupees extra. For pharma, again 1300 extra. For Bangalore campus, you want to appear, 1300 rupees extra. For Indore campus, maybe you want to appear, again 1300 rupees extra. So for all the programs, they are going to charge you 1300 rupees extra. Okay. Now let's come to your retake. Now in retake, in exam you have appeared for the exam and you have also paid for the colleges. You have paid for these 4 courses provided by NMAT. Now in retake 1, you apply for the retake, you pay 2000 rupees, and you apply only for MBA program, which is of 1300 rupees in Mumbai campus, and PGDM program in Mumbai campus, and that is 1300 rupees. Okay, now what will happen? You have not applied for Bangalore here, so your retake one score will not be considered for Bangalore. Okay, you have not applied for Indore over here, so your retake one score will not be considered for Indore. Only your exam score will be considered for Indore. But best of your 2 scores for MBA will be considered for MBA in NMIMS Mumbai. Okay, now in retake 2, if you want to appear, again 2000 rupees more, you apply for MBA in Mumbai campus, also for PGDM in Mumbai campus, and then also for Bangalore, also for Indore, also for Hyderabad, each would cost you 1300 more. But now your retake 2 score will be considered by all these colleges. So now that you have applied for NMIMS Mumbai MBA in all the 3 takes, so your best of 3 score will be considered here. You have applied for Bangalore in 2 takes, so best of your 2 scores will be considered for Bangalore. Okay, got it? So fill the form carefully, be sure whether you want to appear for it or not. It is a very costly exam, but I would recommend that if you are good with verbal, you will be able to clear the exam very easily. Okay. Also, next we are going to come up with videos on the application process of NMAT, where we will be sharing the screenshots of all the stages of the application process. And also the next video will be on the admission process of NMAT. So what processes they have, what is the exam criteria, how much is the weightage on academics and work experience, etc. We will discuss in the third video. So stay tuned with us, subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook as well. Thank you so much.